Hi, my name is Scott Haskins, and I've got a story to tell you that I hope you'll find interesting, entertaining, but I hope it's also instructional for you. I was once contacted by a man in Las Vegas on the telephone who said that he had a priceless Russian Renaissance icon that was important to him and that he needed to make sure that it was exactly what he thought it was. So I told him that we would go through a certain number of analysis, that we would look at certain things under the microscope, that we would take x-rays, that we could look at it with an infrared reflectometer, and that we could do solubility tests and a number of in-lab tests that would help us to determine if it was actually what he thought it would be. But he said that it had been stolen and that it was probably stolen by his attorney. And I told him, well, there's not much I can do unless I've got it, so call me when you find it or if you are able to recoup it. About a month or two later, in the front of my business, a white old model Rolls Royce rolls up and parks in front of my office. And a driver gets out with gloved hands. He walks up to my door with a package and comes in, says, "This is from the man in Las Vegas," hands me the package, and drives away. Fortunately, I still had his phone number because the driver didn't give me anything. The conversation I had with the man in Las Vegas was that just to look at it was going to cost him $200, and that the analysis might run even as high as a couple of thousand, but it would be something that we would probably be able to determine as we go, and if somewhere along the way we found something that wasn't going to work for him as far as the results of the analysis, that we wouldn't have to spend all of the money. But he was going to spend $200 minimum anyway. So he agreed to that, and I opened up the package and looked at it, and immediately I knew what I was looking at. And in fact, this is what the icon looks like. The icon immediately was identifiable as not being Russian, not being Renaissance, and not being a priceless icon, a priceless work of art. The work probably, without having to do any analysis, I recognized as probably being Italian. It was probably done about 1850, and my guess, I'm not an appraiser, but my guess is that it was probably worth about $200. So I called up the fellow in Las Vegas, and I gave him the bad news. There was a long pause on the telephone, and then I said, "But look, I understand your difficulty with this." And I said, "You know, what I can do is I have a client who specializes in icons, and they have a gallery here in the United States, and they have one in, I think it's Zurich, Switzerland. And if you'd like, I'll take the icon to her, and we'll let her, and I won't prejudice her opinion, but I'll let her give me her opinion about what it is." So I took the icon to the gallery owner. And she looked at the painting and said, is it Italian? And I said, "I think so." And she says, "Done about 1850? And I said, "Yeah, I think so. That's my opinion." And I said, "Do you have any idea what it's worth?" And she's a certified appraiser. And she said, $200? And I said, "Yeah, that was what I thought it was worth too." So anyway, I go back to the owner, and I tell him that unfortunately my opinion is confirmed. And there's a long pause, and then he says, "Well, fine." I don't hear from him for about 4 months after I've sent him the bill for $200. Finally, I get him back on the phone. He says, "Well, it's only worth $200. And I said, "Well, you agreed to pay the minimum of $200. That's not my problem. I provided the analysis and the expertise that you wanted." And I said, but tell you what, if you don't want to pay the $200, then I'll just keep the icon. It's a good story. And he says, well, okay, but listen, if I find it at Christie's in New York for auction for $1 million, you're a dead man and I've got contacts. I said, well, not to worry. That's not a problem. About 2 months went by again, and I finally get a phone call. And the phone call is from a lady who says, I hear you have my icon. I said, well, this is the story, and she asked me to tell her the story, so I tell her the story. She begins to laugh and laugh. She is laughing so hard she can hardly catch her breath. In fact, she practically drops the phone. She's laughing and laughing, and I'm just kind of holding the phone apart from my ear, wondering when we're going to have a conversation. Finally, she comes back on the phone and says, I divorced that S of a B, and it was really an awful divorce. We fought over everything, and in fact, you know, sometimes you just have to draw a line in the sand. And that line in the sand for us in our divorce was this icon. And we spent over $100,000 on attorney's fees arguing and fighting over this icon, of course, on principle. He says, your evaluation and your opinion on this is the sweetest thing that's ever happened. Of course, the lady had lost the icon finally in the legal struggle. And this was the best news she had ever had. I was her hero. And of course, the story is a sad story if you're paying fees to an attorney for settling your divorce. And you haven't gotten appraisals. You haven't really checked out the artwork. And all you're going on is emotion and on principle. So there's a moral of the story here, and I'll let you decide what you think that is.